What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy Grandpa Penguin. Today's video, we are actually going to be reacting to it. It is the new episode of The Process video featured on Optic Gaming or Optic Texas's YouTube channel. So we're going to be reacting to it. I actually am super excited how Hex and Hastro resolved the issue, talking about two rivalries merging into one cohesive team. So I'm super excited to see this new episode on The Process. So sit back, relax, grab some popcorn, and let's get right into the video on The Process video. I'm excited to see Skump, Shotzi, Illy, and Dashy, two teams from each team, cohesive into one unit, plus Rainbow, plus Sender. I'm super happy the Sender's back. Rainbow, Codfather, very, very good coach, goes by the fundamentals of Call of Duty, so I'm super excited to see this. Let's get into it. Oh snap.
Oh man, where to begin?
The process, it the was merger.
Like almost to the date, almost to Optic Day, almost to August 14th, when I got the opportunity or the message that said, yo, Optic could be yours again.
I'm so excited that Optic's back.
It took
so
about
much.
2 months so to get much. The deal done. After that, we get into January. Originally, the plan was to turn
NRG.
That was NRG into Optic.
I loved NRG and, you know, as a whole.
Everybody agreed to.
I loved NRG as a whole unit in terms of the whole team. Like NRG, Andy Mill, and Hex, that was. I loved it. I loved when they did the duo podcast, co-CEOs of. That so and the Chicago Huntsman spot plus Optic Chicago, I loved
it, but you know, when it came down to the deal,
everything
the deal
has
terms,
to go in their own way,
just,
you know,
it just didn't make sense for whoever, right? So I said, fine, Optic is not something that can be contained or that can sit on a shelf, right? This is Optic needs to run free and wild, and I decided to do what I am always going
that's
about
the green ball is amazing.
I'm always going to
can't put him in the shelf
for Optic. I feel like I've been in this quicksand pit over the last 3 years since I sold, right? I've been losing my footing, trying to get Optic back to where it was. It's not just, you know, just one.
Wow. Scuff and Nate shot.
Right, it's Optic, and then there's the league, and then there's
Young Hex.
So
the old phenom, the young
Optic
phenom.
How quickly this thing gets done, right? There's a timer on it, and whether or not we're able to meet certain deadlines by certain time. I mean, it just didn't have enough runway. Sort of funding this thing by myself, it hasn't been easy, right? If I had all the time in the world, that's one thing. You know, fortunately, we were able to find a partnership that made sense
Envy.
For Optic.
That must have been weird during the meetings.
We're laughing because we're like,
this is something
microphone's
that we've tried
peaking.
In the past. This is something that we tried with Eon Interactive.
Got
this is something
Dylan
that
over there.
Again.
You
we
got Hitch.
In the bid for Optic when Infinite sold to
got
Immortals.
Roger.
We were the ones that put in this bid, right? So we've tried to make this sort of alignment happen.
That
for a
must
long
have
time.
Sucked.
And
when
the only one thing that
Hex
was
had to make the deal with Infinite,
in the
and
was
then
and
he had to lose his company,
not,
and then now he
the
got his company back.
To be okay with,
then left
you know,
NRG.
Sort of having two iconic brands.
Now with Team NVS merging.
You know, S1.
I was gonna finish on that. I think it's super important that we all feel like all of our teams and brands are under one roof, and that we can openly cheer for all of them and promote them and do those things. Like, you know, I don't want to change anything about Optic at all, and I don't really want to change much about Envy and the Fuel, right?
We collectively as a group just didn't go. It's like
we understood, right? This is like the, you know, call it level 3 of esports, right? And it's gonna get to level 100.
Imagine level 1,000 over 9,000.
Sort of building blocks as to how we're gonna build this foundation.
I mean, goosebumps just thinking
so
about this whole thing.
You know what? None of this is gonna matter 10 to 15 years from now. You know what I mean? Like everything that we've done is going to be thought about, is going to be reminisced about. It's like we're gonna respect this period of time.
Two big companies
esports,
coming together in one
but
roof.
When you're playing at this level, right, at the maturity level that esports is getting to right now, you have to make the most with what you got. You know, one, a group of people that understand what esports is from top to bottom, that aligns with how I think that esports is from top to bottom. That to me is what makes this decision the decision that I needed to make. As much as it's been a little bit of a bumpy road, right? It's a little bit of a bumpy road getting this done. Like, my workload has become a little bit easier immediately, right? The one thing that I've always wanted was to have optic with resources, right? You cannot ever discount the fact that I built what I built by myself. It wasn't until the last year of optic that I got help when I brought Jay on to handle some
FJ,
stuff.
Jay is the worst CEO.
CEO, partnerships, manager, GM,
Jay.
I was everything.
Right? We didn't have Jay
in
our lives.
The cushy help that everybody else has right now, right? I don't have those resources, never had those resources. And when it was time for me to have those resources, when they were available to me, those resources, I took it. Everybody who is a businessman would have took
this. This is why we all like big optic hex.
Okay? My excitement comes from the fact that now, living in Texas, living here, having settled, having the hex quarters, now is time to sort of put some gas on this fire. And that's something that no one has ever seen. No one has seen an optic with me at the helm with resources, right? All I ask is that you judge me by my... I'm not even telling you to look at my history. I'm not even telling you to go see, you know, who brought you the big T's, the Nate Skis, and the Scumpies, right? The Fwizzies. I'm not telling you. My record's there, and no one's... No matter how much shit you talk, no matter how much you like me or don't like me, you cannot erase what I've done for this industry.
That's true. He built the industry.
Having said that, you
one of the successful companies out there.
Do in the future, right?
Popularity.
Some make-believe story that you're making in your head about something. The one thing that I've learned in the last 3 years of doing what I'm doing and fighting for this thing back is that I did the right thing in 2017. In December of 2017, when I sold majority of Optic, it was the right move. If I've learned anything in the last 3 years, it is absolutely that. The way that things happened after that may have not necessarily been exactly what I had planned in my mind, but it was no way for me to foresee that. But the fact is that Optic was ready to grow up. Optic was ready to have a CEO that wasn't juggling 9,000 things. It was time for a CEO that was only focused on growing the business side of Optic. While I continue to be the visionary that I always set out to be, that is a fact. That's what I've learned. And now I am happy that I have the help that, you know, that I've needed. I will always do what's best for Optic. You guys, I cannot begin.
What's best for Optic?
I guess it's not clear enough, you know, what this logo means to me, right? But it is everything, right? Family aside, this is something that I believe in. This is something that I love, and this is something that I will take care of and nurture for the rest of my life. This isn't something... I think people think that because I had an exit of sorts, that I, you know, where I became, you know, wealthy, that meant that I didn't care about this thing. But my vision as to what this would have been with the resources that we had is not what ended up happening. And that's in the past. I don't even want to talk about it anymore. Right? Like, I don't know how to explain, but to do what I have to do to keep optic, right? And I think that my actions speak louder than my words, and I always lead by that sort of example.
Lead by example.
I'm not gonna sit here and tell you this is what my plan is, because it changes. It's a moving target every single time you step on this field, right? What I want people to understand is that, you know, I know what I have to do to make sure that this brand continues to thrive. I know what it is that I gotta
do
to make sure that we escalate, that we scale to where we need to be, to where we were.
I like this sound.
I know what I gotta do, and I'm gonna do it.
The Optic, not the World Championship. Let's go, Supreme. I'm getting goosebumps. Whoa!
Brad, my man. Yo,
what's
going
on?
What's up,
Lon? BTH! Optic Halo?
Where have you been at this whole time?
No, I've been in your heart.
What are those people? The Envy!
Good shit.
The Envy!
Good shit!
Hey, Dashy! Wow. Yo, leave a like in that video. That was so mind-blowing. they introduced probably the NV brand Halo into so technically we have Optic Halo now. So I'm so excited for the Halo team to come on board. I'm so excited. It speaks facts for like the decisions that Hex has to do, you know, brought to the industry with the esports. You got to respect them, you know. I know there's some people that hate them, but you know, you got to respect them in some sort of way. But like, wow, that was a good video. Leave a like, subscribe if you guys are new. I'm super excited for this to happen. For sure we'll do more reaction of these process videos. If you guys are interested, you guys want to see it, like this content, leave a like, subscribe if you guys are new. With that being said, Optic Halo is finally back. I'm getting goosebumps. Whoa!
Right, my man. Yo, what's going on?
These people?
What's up,
Lonnie? BTH! Optic Halo?
Where have you been at this whole time? No, I've been in your heart.
What are those people?